What is going on, Diablo fans? Dobrunsky here, and I apologize for not producing any Diablo-related content for about the last month. I have been swamped IRL, essentially renovating my entire house top to bottom, including my streaming room, which you guys have probably noticed already. But I should hopefully be able to get back onto a little bit more of a consistent schedule. So today's video, I actually want to kind of go against the grain on a lot of the sort of opinion on OP meta, in particular with the Mosaic Assassin. I want to cover the pros and cons of this build, pick apart some kind of common negative arguments that have been pointed against this Assassin, and then also show with some data that it's not really as powerful as people think. I kind of want to say that a lot of people are sort of just afraid of change in general, and that's kind of maybe why they're pushing against it. I don't think this build's OP. I want to break it down again, like I said, pros, cons, talk about some consistent arguments which I don't think hold up, and then again show some test runs compared to some other meta characters to hopefully prove my point. So hopefully you guys enjoy this video. With that being said, let's jump in. So I first want to talk about a lot of the pros associated with this build, because I feel like a lot of people sort of just glaze over the benefits of this new character and only focus on the negatives. So the first very cool pro is I think that there's so many different combinations of gear, build up of charges and martial arts skills that you can use, so that every build is kind of its own unique spin. You're not really kind of like a Blizzard Sorceress, right? Very simple, you max Blizzard, it's synergies, your 1-point wonders, that's it. Gameplay is basically the same. You can alternate between maybe do you want to use Blades of Ice for survivability, or do you focus on Fists of Fire for more damage, which sacrifices your life leech? Do you choose to use Meteor with Phoenix Strike, or maybe the cold or lightning damage variants of Phoenix Strike? Do you actually want to use Flickering Flame to boost fire damage for maybe static targets like Ubers, or do you maybe focus on Griffins so that you can maximize your lightning damage from Claws of Thunder? There's a lot of different gear combinations, and I think that's very exciting. It's sort of shifting away from that static meta of pretty much, you know, like everybody using Shaco or Mara's or Enigma or Grief. I just think that's a good thing for the game. At least it is in my opinion. The second major pro is that it's new and exciting dynamic gameplay. Tele stomping, unleashing charges, building up charges. It's just very fun versus sort of sitting back as a caster and just, you know, unleashing your spells. It's sort of a pseudo melee archetype or whatever. So I actually enjoy playing the character. And the third major pro is that it's not heavily dependent on Infinity or Enigma to excel. I cannot tell you how many people have just spammed my comments of being like, oh yeah, Javazon's great, but you have to have Infinity, or oh yeah, Hammerdin's really cool, the running version sucks, but you really need Enigma for its true viability to shine. That's not the case with this build. You can use Dragonflight to teleport around. You can stack lightning, fire, and cold damage variants so you're not stuck against immunities. It's just a very different build, and it's not kind of hard locked between specific rumors. So I think that's a huge pro for the Mosaic Martial Arts Assassin. Now, in terms of cons, the first major one, it's just undeniable. It is a graphics vomit fest. With my 4080 using DLS on, I think it was performance mode, I was just monitoring my FPS and it was dropping just playing solo testing for the recording of this video. So obviously that's a problem. Now, they're not going to just redesign all the skills kind of like they did with Blizzard in the beta. Like they actually completely changed the animation of the skill Blizzard specifically. That's not going to happen because they're mostly focused on Diablo 4. Like, let's be real, it's basically on life support, like Diablo 2 Resurrected. So that's not going to happen. But maybe a simple fix could be if you're stacking like four different charges, that maybe it automatically kicks off like three of them and it only shows the animation of a single charge. That could be like an easy fix, something that's a little bit more viable than sort of redesigning all the skills. Second major con is stacking charges and keeping them active. It's kind of annoying the start of every run building up your charges, but it's kind of almost hilarious when you like kill all the seal bosses and then you teleport to Diablo, you wait for him to spawn, your charges expire. Or maybe you finish wave three, you're waiting for the Hydras to dissipate when you're bail running, and then you run out of charges again. You have to go teleport somewhere randomly and build up charges. It's very awkward and annoying at times, which kind of perplexes me why people think it is overpowered. And the third major con is that while it's not ideal, it is true that the true viability of the Martial Arts Assassin is locked behind the rumored Mosaic. I've seen a lot of people sort of connect Diablo 3 itemization and Mosaic and not really liking the direction, but let's be honest, there is many different builds in Diablo 2 that have their true viability locked behind a specific rumor. Nova Sorceress, Lightning Sorceress, Fire Sorceress, Fire Druid. They're all heavily locked behind Infinity. Yes, you can play them without, but they really suck until you unlock Infinity. Builds like the Wind Druid are horrible until they get Enigma. Melee characters are very bad until they get Enigma to reposition and get Grief for good damage. There's so many other different examples of in my opinion, builds that kind of work, but their true viability is locked behind a specific rumor. So I don't really think it's any different than the Mosaic Martial Arts Assassin. That's just a huge kind of con and something that's been bothering me that I wanted to address. Yes, the true potential is locked behind Mosaic, but the same can be said for many different builds in Diablo 2. So with the pros and cons out of the way, that should give everybody watching this video a pretty good illustration of where the Mosaic Martial Arts Assassin excels and sort of the drawbacks, because I think that you need to establish that when you're determining whether or not a character is OP. Because we have smiters at level 18 that are killing Ubers, but do people classify the smiter as OP? Not necessarily, because it's really like a targeted niche character, right? It's mostly used for Ubers. People aren't doing general clearing with the smiter. Or the same example of like crushing players 8 Diablo with a couple charge strikes with the Javazon. People don't go, oh, the Javazon is completely overpowered, just because it sort of lacks in other areas like stacking res, teleport speed, etc. Right? There's drawbacks, sort of pros and cons to every different character, and I really think that covering those pros and cons with the Mosaic Assassin helps illustrate where it sort of struggles. I wanted to do a Player's 8 Chaos Sanctuary test, so P8, best possible gear, and I started the timer the second these characters enter the Chaos Sanctuary. And honestly, the way that I did this sort of is in favor of the Martial Arts Assassin, because I didn't include the time it takes to teleport around and stack charges for the clear speed. I had fully stacked charges and every character was buffed, and the second that the characters entered the Chaos Sanctuary, the timer started. Now, in terms of overall clear speed, the Player's 8 Martial Arts Mosaic Assassin cleared Chaos in 2 minutes and 39 seconds. I was able to achieve a 2 minutes and 53 second with a Nova Sorceress. Now, this wasn't fully optimized. There's definitely a couple areas where it could have improved, but it's slightly faster than a Nova Sorceress. But I hit 2 minutes and 17 seconds with the very best possible geared Javazon. So in terms of like clear speed here, I didn't include the time that it takes to build up my charges, because if you have to run around, teleport, build up your charges, the characters are already clearing, right? So the clear speed is relatively similar here. Now, I have had some friends that have posted some very well-made videos. Lucky Luciano is one of my buddies. I'm gonna link his video in the description below. He has a video completely demolishing Ubers. That could, in certain scenarios, stacking those meter charges and just walloping everything, make the character look OP. But you have to remember that with some of these new changes and rumors, you could run a Zodded Eth Ribcracker, have G-Face, use Metamorphosis to stack Crushing Blow, and you could go in with a 6,000 plus life, 100% Crushing Blow, 20,000 plus attack rating Fury Druid that hits very high frames and take out Ubers just as fast. Now, you can't teleport to Ubers, so the overall clear speed wouldn't be quite as quick, but focusing on certain specific niche scenarios and just saying a character is OP, I don't think is very appropriate. But I think based on the Chaos Sanctuary test that it showed, it's not really far better than any of the other characters. I think if anything, it's the same or maybe a hair better. But if you were to take that same test, vacuum test, and apply it to like a Bail Run, when you run out of those charges and you have to teleport around to build them up again, Javazon's just gonna keep going chucking Lightning Fury. So I don't really think it is aggressively out of the normal for being overpowered. But anyways, guys, that basically wraps up today's video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Again, let me know in the comment section below if you guys agree, disagree, think it was a horrible take, and way out there. Feedback is always welcome, as long as you're not a dick. But I genuinely believe that with the value of like martial arts claws going up, different bases, people wanting to use gull runes, the value of gull increasing because of Mosaic, I think overall it's a positive net change for Diablo. It's not perfect. Again, we did cover a lot of the cons, but again, that's basically everything to wrap up this video. Again, please let me know in the comment section below what you guys think. Other than that, hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, if you could throw a like on it, that'd be awesome. And I'll catch you guys on my next video or live stream. Peace out. We already lost. Addicted to the